Okay, let's take a look at the next page where we're going to talk about the four flowers. And we've already discussed these briefly. We're going to go into a bit more detail now. Remember that when we're speaking of these points, 77.08, 77.09 through 77.11, that we're essentially discussing the stomach line. But with these groups of points, we're locating these points on the edge of the tibia rather than one sun away and in the muscles. So the point locations are fairly similar to what we already know. The first point is similar to stomach 36. It's three sun below the knee, below the point stomach 35. But again, it's on the edge of the tibia. And then the point 77.09 is 7.5 sun below the eye of the lateral knee. And then 77.11 is 12.5 sun below stomach 35. Now the point 77.10 is 10 sun distal and from stomach 35. And I think this is where we can easily get confused about these points because they're called the four flowers, but they're needled as a group of three. And in the traditional Dong system, they don't necessarily needle 77.10. It's not necessarily part of the point group. So you can kind of see how this is confusing. And what the fascial lines does then is it really just brings more clarification to why we find all these minute point differences between different teachers and between different resources. And if you observe different doctors in China, you see these little variations where one doctor will move the point a half a sun. And this relates to the points having non-specific functions, meaning that if we needle groups in a similar area, they don't express that much of a difference in terms of the muscles or the nerves or the fascia that they affect. But certainly there are some differences when we start to compare the points that are in the different regions of the thigh and the legs. And as we move distally, they start to have a stronger neurological effect. And if we needle points that are in a tendon, that's going to have a different effect than needling points in a muscle. And also if we needle points that are just skin deep or in the cutaneous regions, like on the fingers or the toes, then that's going to have some differences too. So when we compare the points and as we study them in these different regions, it's really important to just simplify things and understand that part of the reason there's so much variation in this is probably because different teachers through the years have found points that are slightly off the standard locations. And I believe that this has to do with the principle of tensegrity and the way that different people hold tension in different places. So as you study these, don't get too concerned about memorizing which point is half a sun below or half a sun above that other point, because basically we're dealing with the same fascial line and the same nerves, and we're just going to be palpating to find the distal trigger points that will affect the areas that we want to produce a result with. Now, one thing about these four flowers, when we move the points to the edge of the tibia, there's abundant connective tissues in this area. And there's this interosseous membrane that runs between the tibia and the fibula. And so as we move these points to the edge of the tibia, then it's likely that we're affecting the connective tissues more so than if we needle into the points like stomach 36 and stomach 37 that are in the tibialis anterior muscle. So some of the research has shown that the nerves in the muscles and the way that the points in the connective tissues respond neurologically are very similar. So there's some studies where they link the connective tissue points and the muscular points together, and because the results are so similar in the way that they work. So keep that in mind, that there are some differences. Certainly, like if we're needling into the Achilles tendon, then that's different than needling into the gastrocnemius. But because of the way that the fascia surround the muscles and then form the tendons, there's a lot of overlap in the way that these points work as well. And we see that with these four flower points and with the conventional stomach points, where they're indicated for heart and lung disorders. And in the Dong style system, then one thing they do is they'll use bleeding and they'll look for varicose veins or areas where there's purple discolorization with the vessels, and then they'll needle the small ones. Now, I'm not going to go into that. There's classes and courses that cover all that, and it's not a technique that I use a whole lot. However, it's just something I want to mention, because occasionally I will needle these, and if you notice little varicose veins there and purple discoloration, it's quite helpful to bleed them for certain people. The next point here reads gastric and intestinal conditions, ulcers, abdominal pain, and distension. So these are typical type of things that we use the points for, such as stomach 36 and stomach 37. We can use these four flower points for these conditions. And in when we look at these fascial planes, then we can see the way that they are related to the rectus abdominis. And I would remind you of the simple exercise that we can do where we contract our quads. So take a little time right now to do that and focus on straightening your legs and tightening your quadricep muscles. And notice how that tension in contracting the quads will move up into the rectus abdominis muscle. So tighten your quadriceps as much as you can and just simply notice how that tension within the system moves up and will start to produce tightening or sensation within the rectus abdominis area. So this simple exercise, it demonstrates this fascial relationship between the quads and the way that it gets transferred up into the system. And you may even notice as you do that exercise, go ahead and try it again and see if you can notice it also tighten not only the abdominals, but also the sternal fascia as well. So these really simple demonstrations convey the way that the myofascial system is interrelated and can help to start to lay down an anatomical foundation for why these points on the stomach meridian and on the legs can be used for lung and heart disorders, as well as the gastrointestinal conditions. Now, these points are also indicated for eye conditions, toothaches, bruxism, elbow pain, and 77.09 is also used for shoulder pain. Now, in the traditional points, we'll use stomach 38 for shoulder pain, and it really works best for lateral and anterior shoulder pain. And the point 77.09 is essentially, it's located on the same horizontal line. So stomach 38 is 8 sun below stomach 35, and then 1 sun lateral to the edge of the tibia. But then 77.09 is traditionally located 7.5 sun below stomach 35, and then on the edge of the tibia. So here we see this relationship then between these two points being so closely located, and that they're both indicated for shoulder pain. Now, I think I may have already discussed that if we look at this and question why these can be useful for shoulder pain, we should recall that the clavicle plays a fundamental role in maintaining the integrity of the shoulder joint. And so by needling this point, either stomach 38 or 77.09, it's going to produce a result through these fascial lines and up into the medial area of the clavicle, where we got the SCM and the sternal fascia joining together there at the manubrium. So I think that this is probably why, because that clavicle will act like a lever in the shoulder joint. And if there's forward rotation of the shoulders, that will also displace the clavicle and cause tension in the front of the sternum and in that area. So when there is that sort of forward rotation that will often produce anterior shoulder pain, then when we needle these points in the distal location, it will alleviate pain in the anterior shoulder, and that's likely being modulated through the clavicle and the myofascial associations that it has with this superficial front line. So again, we've got a very clear anatomical basis for starting to understand how these points work in the way that they do, and we can apply this way of reasoning and thinking to a lot of the indications that exist for both the traditional points as well as for Master Dong's points. Let's see, that last point, we've already spoke about this. Look for bands of tension in spider veins for bloodletting. So again, you know, do your palpation, look for the trigger points, look for these distal trigger points. And if you find them in the stomach meridian, in the belly of tibialis anterior muscle, then great, needle those. But if the points along the edge of the tibia are more sensitive than the stomach meridian points, then needle those. So these are probably the group of points, when I compare them to the traditional points, that I alternate between the two the most. For some groups of points, I always go with the Master Dong points because they're just more effective and more powerful. But for other points, I will alternate between the Master Dong points and the traditional points. And these are the ones that I alternate with the most because of the variation in people and the way that they respond with pressure and palpation.